boys, hey girl. Welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipe. I'm feeling a whole lot better now that I'm at home. Although whilst I was in the hospital, Miss JB took it upon herself to reorganize my office, thinking it would make me want to move into the man cave with my office, or my computer room, basically. But actually, she did me a favor, because now I got a nice work desk in there, and I'll go show y'all that in a minute. Yeah, so I lost a toe, and it wasn't due to diabetes or anything. I have peripheral neuropathy. Means you can't really feel your toes, your feet that much. And the anesthesia they gave me and the antibiotics that they gave me while I was having that toe removed shut my kidneys down, or almost shut them down all the way. So then they started, had to give me a different kind of antibiotic. And they had to give me that strong antibiotic for the surgery because of the staph infection. They was worried about it getting in my bloodstream and killing me. So now I've got, I'm doing antibiotics at home. I've got a PICC line installed. I don't know if y'all know what that is, but it's a catheter that you put medicine in, and they got a tube that goes down around up one of my veins going back to my heart. And we do that twice a day. But it's better than being in a hospital. And I wasn't sure, I lost track of time. I was in a hospital for 11 days. I totally lost track of time. And so I'm walking with a cane. My balance isn't worth a crap. Because without that big toe, it's hard to balance. So I use the cane mainly for balancing, which cane, you know, if I walk without it, or actually just close my eyes without the cane in my hand, I'll go to fall over and I can't balance. So let's go over here into the computer area and see what Miss JB's brilliant idea was. Turn on some light in here. Light. Let there be light. My workstation was set up right over here on this desk. And that's where, you know, I edited all my videos. It had two computer monitors. But now it's a nice little workstation that I can work on things with, and that's soldering iron, all kind of, a bunch of tools just tucked away over there. So we rearranged things to over here. She had this little computer desk and got it set up. And look at the Barbecue Forever sign right about there. There it is. It's actually a plate, a metal plate. So yep. Now we're set up on this side. Wake him up there, and there we go. Yeah. It's all awake. You can tell by the lucite tube and everything. But so this is my new work area, and I can sit down and take the cane and adjust the camera. Oops. Wanting to roll away from me and adjust the camera and relax. As far as cooking, I can't stand them on my feet too long. I've actually got to prop them up for as much as I can stand anyway, and just to keep the swelling down. And you know, I've still got stitches, and they'll be coming out probably another week, I think. So, as far as cooking, people been bringing us stuff by, We got more food in the refrigerator than we know what to do with in the freezer. Got boudin, got cracklings, got all the essential items, you know, red beans and rice and jambalayas. So we're just having a grand old time down the bayou here. And I'll be back to normal cooking. It's going to be still a bit because I just can't stand up for that long. You know, I was wanting to tell y'all, when y'all watch a video, say if it's 10 minutes long, I might have been standing in front of that stove for 2-3 hours. But y'all are just getting the highlights, more or less, on camera. And I just can't do that right now. You know, I've got a tall bar stool back here that I can sit on, and but that's not really propping my feet up, you know. So just kind of giving y'all a little heads up on what's going on, and now that 'tis the season of Christmas is upon us, If I don't get to talk to y'all again before Christmas, Merry Christmas to everybody, okay? And we'll have a good one here down the bayou. Miss JB was busy over there setting up a little Christmas village and wanted me to set up a train around it. All my train tracks are outside in the storage room, and I'm sure they'd have to take a Scotch-Brite and clean them. They probably got some rust on the rails. You know, it just won't make good contact. She's still working on it. I got to put up the train. But, we've been going out to eat some as well. But we got enough food here to feed an army. And I think I'm going to go heat up a stick of boudin right about now. That'd be just fine with me. So, till the next adventure, and it's going to be that roof thing that I was telling y'all about a while back, where me and JP, my son-in-law, are going to get together and show y'all 3 or 4 different ways to make a roof. And that make all kind of things with a roof. Naturally gumbo, but you can put it in a lot of other things. Like beef stew, for instance, or you can make a gravy with it, brown gravy, to put on hamburger steaks, or just anything you want. Put it on a baked potato, if you'd like, if it's seasoned properly. And, of course, we'll show you the traditional way, which I've shown y'all, but we'll also do one in the nuke and in the oven, and you know, you use roux for naturally gumbo is one of the main things, but you can also put, there's another gumbo, you can also put it in stews as a crawfish stew, or make gravy with it for hamburger steaks, and or put it on baked potatoes, whatever you want to put it on. You can even use it in a beef stew. So, I'm back. I got a haircut. Yeah. It ain't no big deal. This JB not using that big old monitor. See, my two monitors are two different sizes. Wake up, computer. Yeah, you see, I got two different sizes. She got another one sitting right over there that she ain't using. That's this size. So I ought to swap them while she ain't paying attention. She ain't using it. Just soon keep it warmed up for her. Homeboy. There she is. She snuck up behind me. Now here we is in the man cave area. And I was kind of wanting to show y'all. I got a new exhaust system for the car. That's 2.5 inch tubing. It's in these two boxes down here. If I can get my son to help me put it on.
All this is 2.5-inch mandrel bent tubing, unlike this 2-inch, which is non-mandrel bent, and it leaves those kinks and flattens out the tubing. If you bend it a lot, it'll flatten it in half. We're also going to eliminate this ESE valve with a spacer, because all that is a restriction, and they'll stick. It was stuck half open on this car.
I think you're getting too much light from somewhere. Oh, that one's shining right on the camera. Back it off. There's some overhead track lighting back there. And, yeah. Also, that car came in 74. Back in the 70s, they had the Space Saver spares. And that was standard. Optional was a full-size spare. Which my first one that I had, brand new off the showroom floor, I special ordered it, and I ordered full-size spare. And my temporary spare is wore out. I mean, it's just dry rot. It's original tire. So this is the size tire that's on the car. And I bought a cheap rim and a cheap tire. So if I do have a flat, I can just keep on driving. I don't have to go 45 miles an hour on a temporary spare. They ain't got much tread on it.
These are stupid. They should have never made them.
I even found, back then when I was coming up, I even found an old, it's made by Tenor Electronics. It's an 8-track player. I don't know where I could put it, though. It's big. It's got a little tape light underneath. You can turn the motor off, turn the drive motor off, and insert a FM box into it. It's actually an FM tuner. It's got a place on the side where you plug a antenna wire into it and go out to your antenna. So you can have FM, because most of the cars just came with AM radios back then.
It was powered from the tape deck itself. And the antenna wire card plugged in on the right side.
And I had one just like this in my old car. You know, the problem with 8-tracks is, if I've got a recorder, a Sony 8-track recorder, it still works, is different manufacturers and different brand of tapes, and depending on how they're recording, sometimes they'll play 3 tracks at once, or they'll play part of track 1 and part of track 2 at the same time. But this one's got a fine-tuning adjustment on it, so you can move that head up and down to get it dialed directly on the track that the tape is on, which is pretty cool, because most of them didn't come with that. You were just screwed. This is a nice unit.
They got a fellow that reconditions them. He can even replace the amp with a really powerful amp. Add Bluetooth to them, anything you want.
I don't know where I'm mounted, though. I had my other one underneath the glove box, hanging down into the passenger's leg room area. He just had to eat you know what. I may pull the glove box, the actual box, out from behind the door and mount it up in there. And it's already got a center console, I mean, and a map pocketed up in front to shifter, so it really don't need 3 storage areas in the car. You got a back seat. Throw junk back there. I did want to tell y'all about that, though. Yeah, man, can't see. All kind of stuff. Old Sony, reel-a-reel. It works, too.
Now, everything here works. It works well. This stuff was built in the 70s, except for the reel-a-reel, which was from the 50s. And that 8-track recorder works, too. And these sound fantastic and have 12-inch woofers in them. But we crossed them over and used this little carver here to drive these 18-inch subs. And it'll rattle everything off the top of that cabinet, including the JBL. Let me mention that Technic says pre-out main end jacks.
That JBL speaker's over there in the corner. Guess y'all can see them. All kind of goodies. Drums way back over in the corner. Popcorn machine. Gotta have a popcorn machine. You know that. And you got trains set up for the grandkids and a monorail. Like at Disney World, you know. Yeah. Okay, that's enough of me yapping. Let me go to the other room and play. Go do something, go prop my foot up, yeah.
Been doing a little tuning on the car. Let's see what happens. I think it's running pretty good. If I shifted it manually, it would have snatched second gear and chirped the tires, but it was just in drive mode for grandma.
Okay, we'll talk at y'all later. Merry Christmas. A boy, a girl, a bye.